super hot outside, like 100 degrees. Of course, it's prime time that you want to take the kids and hit the beach or the pool.
Or the sprinkler. We got those too.
Yep.
But sure to know to keep an eye on kids around water. But do you know what to look for when it comes to something called dry drowning? It's a very real and very dangerous thing. Here's Corey Heppola.
Tragedy in Texas. 4-year-old Frankie goes swimming. Days later, he starts feeling sick, like a stomach bug, his dad says. And then he stops breathing and dies. Doctors say Frankie had fluid in his lungs and around his heart. He died from dry drowning. Dry drowning, what is that? Let's ask Andy Olson, an ER doctor at Park Nicolet's Methodist Hospital.
Dry drowning, first of all, is really, really rare. But I think classically, it'll be a child who is underwater for a little while. They come up and they cough and gag a little bit, but then seem fine. And then what can happen is several hours later, they might start to have some trouble breathing.
How exactly does that happen, medically speaking?
Really what you're talking about is that reflex to close off the airway. It's called your epiglottis. It flips closed. It's what keeps you from drowning every time you try to drink a glass of water. So that's really the issue, is that closes, your lungs try to expand, and there's nothing to expand against, and that's traumatic to the lungs.
Is this just a near-death experience type of situation, or could it be just like, oh man, they went underwater for a second?
Well, I mean, all it takes is that moment where they're trying to breathe really strongly against a closed-off airway. Again, and even when this happens, in most cases, the children turn out to be fine. They might have a little bit of fluid building up and then it'll all resolve.
So would there be any symptoms connected with this?
Well, right away, maybe not. But, you know, within 4, 5, 6 hours, you would expect to see some just trouble breathing, maybe a little coughing, wheezing is possible too.
Okay, but what do you do if that does happen? Is there any treatment?
So there's no, you know, antibiotic or anything you give. In a lot of cases, you know, if kids are having some of the symptoms, they'll be admitted to the hospital and monitored. When in doubt, we're always open. We're always happy to take a look. Sometimes we decide, well, let's get a chest x-ray. Sometimes, you know, we're just able to listen to the lungs, look at the child, check their vital signs and say, hey, you know, this child is fine.
I also asked Dr. Olson about pool water versus lake water, if that made a difference with dry drowning. He said that he didn't think so. And we did talk about the case in Texas. He called it puzzling because of the symptoms and how long it was from when the boy went swimming to when he first had trouble breathing, which was, as you guys know, about a week.
Mm-hmm.
So he thought that something else, I mean,
might
he's not connected.
Underlying
correct.
Health condition or something?
Correct. Okay. I mean, obviously he's not connected to that case at all, but he did say that something else seems to be off here.
Well, as parents, and me as the newest parent of the group, there's too much to worry about anymore. I just, like, you can't put it, you have to put some of the stuff out of your mind, don't you? I mean, just to get through every day.
You don't have to take your kids to the ER if they cough up some water, yeah. But I mean, the symptoms, I mean, that was a great question that you asked, because it is something you want to monitor. If there are serious symptoms after they went under and took some water in, hey, why not? Get it checked out.
And if anything, we learn anything from this, is that it is very rare,
right?
Yes. Right. This does not happen all the time.
Favorite part of that.
Yes,
whole story.
He said it's very, very rare. But if you do see some symptoms that just look off, don't be afraid to get them checked out.
Use your gut.
Yep.
All right.
Thank you,
Corey. Appreciate it. We'll be right back.